Hi all, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to study about grade 10 physics. Topic is reflection of light. Subtopic is linear magnification produced by mirrors. So what is linear magnification produced by mirrors? So position of object from the mirror defines the size of the image formed by the spherical mirror. So where will be the object placed? That type of image will be formed. Now object is placed at C or between F and P or beyond C or at focus. So position of object from the mirror defines the size of image formed by the spherical mirror. So that way. Now image formed can be bigger than object, equal to object or smaller than object. These are the three possibilities of the size of the image which is formed: bigger than object, equal to object or smaller than object. So linear magnification gives the value of the size of image relative to the object. Whatever the size of object is, accordingly the size of image will change or it will be formed. So magnification means enlargement of the image. So magnification formula is height of the image upon height of object. So whatever height of object is, whatever height of image is upon whatever the height of object is, that ratio is giving the magnification value. Now the ratio of the height of image to the height of object is known as linear magnification. So how much long the image will be, that is what we mean by linear magnification. So m is equal to h2 upon h1. M is magnification, h2 is height of image, and h1 is height of object. Now let us apply the sign convention to the mirror formula. Sign convention rules remain the same, which I have discussed in my video of sign convention. You can refer it to grade 10 physics playlist and find out that video. So height of the object is h1, which is always positive because it is kept above the principal axis. As it is placed above principal axis, and virtual image is formed above principal axis. So h2, height of virtual image, will always be positive. Virtual images are formed beyond the mirror, behind the mirror, and they are virtual and erect. So because they are formed above principal axis, they are also considered as positive if the image is virtual. Real images are formed below the principal axis, so height h2 of real images is negative. So in the numericals, when you are solving it, if it is given that the image formed is virtual, it is understood that the image will be taken as positive because it is forming above the principal axis, and if the image is real, it will be taken as negative because it is forming below the principal axis. So that way we have to interpret whatever given to us in the numericals. So for virtual image, h1 is the height of the object, positive, and h2 is also positive as image is formed above principal axis. So magnification of virtual image will be h2 upon h1, always positive. Now if magnification has positive sign, suppose in numerical if magnification is given and it has a positive sign, that means that image is virtual and erect. So either of the way it can be given in the problem sums. Magnification is given and its sign is positive, that means it is virtual and erect image. So for real images, H1 is height of the object, which is positive always, and H2 is the height of image, which is negative, as image is formed below the principal axis. So magnification of real images is minus H2 upon H1. So if magnification has negative sign, then the image is real and inverted. In problem sums, if magnification is given with minus sign, the image is real and inverted. That we have to understand. Then next, for concave mirror, the images can be formed are virtual image as well as real image. Concave mirror can form two images, virtual as well as real. Virtual image is formed and magnification is positive. Real image is formed and magnification is negative. And then convex mirror. For convex mirror, always the image is formed as virtual image because it is formed behind the mirror. So convex mirror always forms virtual image, so its magnification is always positive. So this is the sign convention and value of magnification. If a magnification value what we get is greater than 1, image is magnified and enlarged. If it is equal to 1, image is of same size. If it is less than 1, image is diminished or smaller in size than the object. And if we study for mirrors, for concave mirror, because concave mirror can form all three types of images, so m could be greater than 1, equal to 1 or less than 1. And for convex mirror, m is always less than 1 because always diminished images are formed behind the mirror. So this is the value, we have to understand. And for plane mirror, this is very important. For plane mirror, M is equal to 1 because image size is equal to object size. So for plane mirror, M is always equal to 1. For convex mirror, M is less than 1. And for concave mirror, all three possibilities are there. So this is how the understanding of this magnification, linear magnification produced by mirrors, I have tried to explain you. I hope this topic would be clear to you, and subscribe my channel for more such educational videos. Like and share it with your friends, and thank you for watching.